This Mitsubishi mini-split AC indoor circuit powers on, but when it does, the LED starts blinking. As soon as it gets electricity, it begins blinking continuously and will keep blinking as long as the PCB is powered. If the upper LED is continuously blinking, it indicates a serial communication error. A serial communication error occurs when the indoor and outdoor units cannot properly communicate with each other. In this case, since I haven't installed the outdoor PCB with it, it's understandable that this error would appear. Normally, if the indoor and outdoor units aren't connected, this error would occur, but the situation here is a bit different. First, I'll turn off the power. Now, let's understand this problem properly, which will make it easier to work on the issue. On this PCB, you can see labels such as LN, S1, S2, S3. This means that the main power supply first goes to the indoor unit and then from there to the outdoor unit. In most brands, what happens is that when the power goes from the indoor unit to the outdoor unit, there's a control system in place. The authority of this control system lies with the indoor unit. This control system typically includes a switching relay, which allows the supply to pass to the outdoor unit only when the relay is switched on. In this case, the problem is that this relay isn't turning on, even if it's left powered for hours. As a result, the supply isn't reaching the outdoor unit, and until that happens, communication won't start between the two units. Now, the relay installed here is a 12-volt DC-operated relay, so let's check whether the relay is receiving the proper voltage. Normally, what happens is that when electricity is supplied to this switching relay, it energizes the coil inside it. When the coil is energized, it creates a magnetic field, which attracts the metal part located here. Through this magnetic pull, the metal connects with the relay. When it connects, the points located underneath it also connect, and this allows the power supply to reach the outdoor unit. Now, I will turn the power back on. Normally, you should hear a clicking sound when the relay switches, because when the relay operates, it makes a tick sound. However, no such sound is coming from it, which indicates that there is a problem. Let's examine these points, the points responsible for energizing the relay. Now let's check the voltage here. The readings show something like 1 point something and then 0.678. fluctuating like this. This means that the proper supply needed to energize the relay isn't coming through correctly, which is why the coil won't work in any case. To resolve this issue, we'll turn off the power again and also remove the fan motor. There's a lock here that, when pressed downward, allows the PCB to slide out. We'll also disconnect the remaining wires and components. There is a mark to remove the circuit carefully. When I pressed it, it came out. Now the PCB is out, and below it, there is this room temperature sensor. To remove it, lift it up carefully. It has come out now. Both PCBs are out of the box, and this one has also been removed. There are small locks. Press them, and they will come out. Now there's also a lock here. I pressed it, and this PCB has come out of the cover. Now we will start diagnosing why this relay is not turning on. There will be a complete procedure to follow for this. If we look at the backside of the PCB, there's a relay pin. This is the output point, and this is where the voltage is coming in at 220 volts. From here, the switch point goes in this direction. Now, if we look here, this black wire comes to S1. This is the main line point. Similarly, there's another point here, and in between them, there is a diode for safety protection. I checked it, and it's perfectly fine. Now that we have checked these two points, this point goes in that direction and then turns here. When I traced it, I found that it leads to the positive point of the 12-volt DC voltage regulator, where the output is coming from. Now, if we trace the next point, it goes from here and then narrows with a jumper. However, you can see that at this first point, there is another jumper, and this jumper is going in this direction. I'll explain why this second point is going in that direction later. Look, this connects to pin number 6, and then it attaches to pin number 7. Now, if we flip the PCB over and check the power PCB, you'll see that there are wires connected from 1 to 9. Since we have connections for 9, 8, and this connector for number 7, when we check pin number 7 in continuity mode, we hear a beep. Similarly, we can check the other connector at pin number 6 to see if it's connecting properly from this side. I'll explain why the positive and negative are coming to this PCB. The relay needs 12 volts to turn on. Similarly, the DC motor inside the swing mechanism of the unit also operates at 12 volts. This is why the connections are coming to this PCB, as they are likely related to the swing motor. Now, the 12 volts have gone to the motor. This connector is for swing motor, but the other point is also important. The negative or ground point doesn't go directly to the relay. It is controlled, and the microcontroller manages it. I will explain how. Now, the positive point is not our concern. Our entire concern is with the ground. The ground is controlled by a Darlington array on this PCB, BA12003BF Darlington array, which is 14 pins component that controls the relay's ground. When we check whether the ground is actually controlled from here, we need to confirm this. So we place the multimeter probe on pin number 7 to start testing. On pin number 15, we see continuity, which means it is connected to pin 15. Now, we will reapply electricity to the PCB. I have applied power to it. Now we will check the voltage here. This relay point is the positive point, so we place one probe here, and the other probe goes here, but there is no voltage output coming from it. Next, I will check this same point on pin number 7 of this PCB, because pin 7 is ground. You can see that stable 12 volts are coming to this point. Now, we're going to remove the Darlington array from the system. I have removed it. After that, I replaced the Darlington array, but before that, I did some other work. Look here, I removed this relay and replaced it with another relay, which is approximately 20 amps and fits this model. Now, I will reapply electricity to the unit, and both of the LED lights are on. To test if the output is working properly and if the relay is functioning, I connected the multimeter probe to the output and placed the other probe on the neutral to easily check if electricity is flowing. At this point, I have turned the unit on again, and both of the LED lights are lit. We will wait a little, about 2 to 3 minutes, for the switching relay to turn on. Now, the relay has switched on, and 228 volts are coming through, but the indoor motor has stopped. The reason the indoor motor stopped is that the system is so fast that as soon as the switching happens, the outdoor unit's relay should activate. If the outdoor unit's relay does not activate, the system goes into continuous blinking mode, meaning the outdoor unit is not attached, which is causing this problem. Let's attach the outdoor unit and see if it works properly. Now, we will do the final testing to see if the PCB is working correctly or not. I'm applying electricity, and at this moment, both of the LED lights are on. We will wait to check if what we did is working. Listen, you can hear the switching sounds from both sides, and the power supply is going out to both sides now. We will wait to see if any error occurs. So far, no error has appeared, which means the PCB has been successfully repaired, and the error has been resolved. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.